Today, we are tackling a topic that's not just controversial but deeply concerning, the Waqf Board and its draconian influence on property rights in India. Originally intended to manage Islamic endowments for charitable purposes, this institution has now become a tool of widespread land disputes and property encroachments. And the recent amendments proposed in the parliament have only heightened the urgency of this issue. The Waqf Board has been exercising extraordinary powers, often declaring lands and properties as Waqf without proper justification or evidence. Shockingly, there have been instances where even ancient Hindu temples, some over 1500 years old, have been declared as Waqf property. Now let's put that into perspective. Islam as a religion is around 1300 years old. So how can a structure predating Islam by centuries be suddenly claimed by the Waqf Board? This isn't just a hypothetical scenario. Across India, there have been numerous cases where people have had to fight tooth and nail against the Waqf Board to retain their homes and lands. Entire communities have been thrown into turmoil, with families forced into lengthy legal battles to protect properties that have been in their possession for generations. The Waqf Board's sweeping authority allows it to declare any property as Waqf, often without proper notice. And once the declaration is made, it's an uphill battle to reclaim it. And here's the most alarming part. 77% of Delhi's land is reportedly claimed as the Waqf property. Yes, you heard that right. More than 3/4 of the capital city's land is under the Waqf Board's control or claimed as Waqf property. This staggering statistic puts the scale of the issue into perspective and highlights the extent of the Waqf Board's reach. Even the Waqf Board is reportedly the third largest landholder in India, following the Indian Railways and the Defence Department of India, which includes properties spanning 9.4 lakh acres with an estimated value of Rs. 1.2 lakh crores. This kind of power in the hands of any institution is dangerous. It's not just about the control over properties, but also about the transparency and fairness in how these decisions are made. The government and the Waqf Boards must ensure that their actions are just, transparent, and in line with modern legal standards. Otherwise, the perception of the Waqf Board as a draconian institution will continue to grow. Take the case of a family in Karnataka whose ancestral land was suddenly claimed by the Waqf Board. Despite having all the legal documents and proof of ownership, they spent years in court fighting to reclaim what was rightfully theirs. Or the instance in Tamil Nadu, where entire village had been marked as Waqf property, leaving residents in constant fear of losing their homes. The Waqf Board in its current form has become a draconian tool that undermines the property rights of Indian citizens. It's time to seriously reconsider its existence on Indian soil. Why should a law that can arbitrarily take away someone's home or land be allowed to persist? The solution isn't just in amending the law, it's in abolishing it altogether. As citizens, we must stand up for our rights. We cannot allow an institution to operate above the law, especially when it threatens the very fabric of our society. It's time for the government to take a hard look at the Waqf Board and the damage it's causing. The call for its complete removal is not just necessary, it's long overdue. If you believe in the importance of property rights and the need for justice, join the conversation. Share this video, spread awareness, and let's push for the real change. The Waqf Board has overstayed its welcome, and it's time for it to go.
Finding this story interesting? Then stay tuned with the Cognizant Crew for more such videos, and never let your curiosity die.